Well, thank you for participating. Professor Dr. Rudhangurwa, Director of the Center for the History of Women Philosophers and Scientists. We're doing a short interview for Emily Chatelier's birthday, kind of special on social media. And we would like to ask you, what is your motivation to do the research on Emily Chatelier?
So thank you very much for your question and for your initiative. Why do we have to read Emily Chatelier? Because you can't do philosophy without reading Emily Chatelier. This is as if you were trying to become a philosopher without reading Plato.
That's a great take, very important. So in your lifetime, during all your research on Emily Chatelier, what do you think is your most significant discovery you made up till now?
So what I think what is the achievement of Chatelier is that it was she. One thinks that it was mainly Kant, but I think one has to correct this perspective into the history of philosophy. I think it is she has a great part in this turn, how we understand science and philosophy. Chatelier put an end to the science is true narrative that was built upon the Aristotelian causal argumentation. She understood that science is a construction of as many as possible good reasons that we can give to something. And others needed much longer to understand that, and many in that period copied from her without naming her. So I think it is her who made the breakthrough, and it was then Kant, reading Du Châtelet, who understood very well that she had these ideas.
Yeah, and what are you hoping to contribute in the future? What is your goal? What are you looking forward to? I mean, we already reached so many goals, but what is the next step?
So I think so many people let's say Judith Zinsser and Kerving and Brown and Hartmut Hecht and Dieter Suski and Julie Hayes and so many people and have contributed to do so many and to write so many good things on Du Châtelet. So, and I would include myself now, so we have worked so very hard. And I think we did a very good job. And why did we do a very good job in doing so? We have achieved to inflame the enthusiasm on Emily du Châtelet in the younger generation. So I think we have done our job already.
Thank you. We are very thankful for that. Are there any last words you want to tell our followers or try to inflame them more to do research on Emily du Châtelet?
I mean, so doing Emily du Châtelet is a start to philosophy, let's say, I think that will become as important as the research in Kant. And this means that for everyone, there is something to work upon. You know, Emily du Châtelet and Descartes, Emily du Châtelet and other women in her time, Desilières, for example, Emily du Châtelet and Lametrie, Emily du Châtelet and so on. It is nearly infinite. And I'm hoping that this will become a truth within the next 50 years.
We hope so too. Thank you very much for this interview.
Thank you very much for having me.